1,000 bottles with a value of more than $250,000. This is liquid gold, and those sniffing it, sipping it, and spitting it know it. But behind the notepads and the intense scribbling is an industry hoping not to go flat.
How much has the champagne industry grown? Did it lose any of the fizz, so to speak, during the economic crisis?
So yes, you know, in the past 5 years have been a time of less growth and more stability in the UK market. But certainly, you know, we are and we will remain the number one export market for champagne for a very long time. And I think the beauty of London is that we are attracting, the city is attracting an awful lot of emerging consumers. So as they come here, they are also contributing to our market, you know, remaining top of the box.
Helping it to regain that spot, a new way of dining where bubbly is part of a casual menu. Think hot dogs and champagne. According to the Champagne Bureau, roughly 30 to 35% of all champagne sold here in the UK is being drunk in bars and restaurants.
Globally, we cannot say that champagne has not been affected by the recession, but the positive thing about it is that the sparkling wine category globally is growing and champagne is still very much a leader.
The message this year is clear, champagne is back, and that's pretty understandable. The European economy doing slightly better, and that basically means that you and I have a bit more purchasing power. We can spend our money on more refined, sophisticated drinks. But champagne, better watch out. It has a lot of catching up to do. Cava and Prosecco, if you remember, did particularly well during the recession. So while we're not seeing corks pop left, right and centre here, there is definitely room for celebration. Isa Soares, CNN, London. Cheers.